Hi guys, and welcome to another revision video here. This time we're looking at the 1798 Rebellion, and specifically we're going to look at why the rebellion failed. This tends to come up quite a bit in question 5 as one of the accounts, so why the rebellion failed. But to understand why it failed, we're going to revise the reasons for the rebellion and the course of the rebellion. So what were the reasons for the rebellion? There was four kind of main reasons for the 1798 rebellion. The first one was the power of the Protestant ascendancy. So this was mainly the Anglican Church. They were only about 15% of the population, but they controlled the Parliament, they controlled everything. Another reason for the rebellion was the penal laws. So while some of them had been reduced in the 1770s, there were still these laws against Catholics and against Presbyterians as well that made them subject to this Protestant ascendancy. There was also massive poverty within the countryside and also the influence of the American and French Revolution. So one of the influences of the French Revolution, the American Revolution, was the setting up of this organization known as the United Irishmen. So in France, they would have met in cafes and stuff like this, thanks to the Enlightenment thinkers, where they'd go and they'd trade ideas. So Ireland set up one of these as well. So the United Irishmen was founded in Belfast in 1791. The main ideas were we wanted to unite all the religions and to reform the Irish Parliament, and wanted to reduce the English power in Ireland. At the beginning, they didn't want to set up a republic, or they didn't want to separate Ireland from England. They just wanted fairer conditions. But in 1794, they were banned and became a secret oath-bound society. They were banned because Britain had entered war with France and was now paranoid about any organizations that were talking about moving away from England. They considered it treason. As they pushed this society underground, they became more radical, and now they wanted a republic, and now they wanted a rebellion. So the start of the rebellion, how did it start? So before it actually began, all the leaders of the United Irishmen who were planning the whole thing were arrested. Britain had an amazing network of spies around the place, and they were able to arrest all the key people, such as Lord Edward Fitzgerald. But the rebellion went ahead anyway. So the signal was that there was going to be attack the mail coaches, so the post didn't come, so everyone knew, okay, it's time to start the rebellion. But most of these were put down fairly easily. The main exception to these rebellions that were being put down was Wexford. So the rebellion in Wexford was led by Father John Murphy, and the people of Wexford, they rebelled because of attacks by yeomanry and by militia. So the yeomen were these kind of British-backed part-time troops, while the militia were kind of full-time troops. So they initially won at Owlert, then they took Enniscorthy and Wexford. And when they went to Wexford, they freed one of the United Irishmen, known as Bagginal Harvey. They also took Gorey, but they were eventually defeated at New Ross and Arklow before the ultimate defeat at Vinegar Hill. There were a few other rebellions of note. So there were two attempted rebellions in Ulster, one in Antrim under Henry Joy McCracken, and one in Down by Henry Monroe. But both of these lasted probably about 10 days. The final part of revolutionary action was that the French landed in May and August of 1798 after the rebellions had been crushed. So they defeated the English at Castle Bar. This was known as the races at Castle Bar. But they were eventually defeated in a place called Ballinamuck near the River Shannon. And one of the key figures that we haven't quite discussed yet is Wolfe Tone. So Wolfe Tone was the leader of the United Irishmen. He'd been one of the key figures of the planning of this rebellion. He was on the French boats to try to land in 1796 at Bantry Bay. And he convinced the French to send more troops after defeat at Ballinamuck. They had landed with 1,000 troops in Mayo, and this time they were going to land with 3,000 troops. But as they were off the coast of Donegal, they were caught. They were brought in by Lough Swilly, and Wolfe Tone was tried, and he was found to have committed treason. The punishment for treason is to get hung, but he wanted to be shot as a soldier. He didn't believe he was treasonous. So instead of being seen as a traitor, he decided to commit suicide instead. So now on to the main question. Why did the rebellion fail? So there's four main points. And what we're going to do is we're going to say the point, and then we're going to give examples of how this manifested. So the first main point is poor organization. Okay. Examples of the poor organization was that the leaders were arrested, so there was nobody really leading the rebellion. Another example is that rebellions began at different times. So you're talking about the one in Wexford begins after skirmishes are put down in Meath and Dublin. The rebellion in Ulster begins right at the end of the Wexford rebellion. And then the fact that the two in Ulster, Antrim and Down, they didn't even meet up and they were defeated separately. Another example of the poor organization was the French landed in Connacht after the rebellion had ended. So they didn't land where there was fighting going on. They landed completely away on the other side of the country. And another example of the poor organization was the Wexford troops at New Ross. These were not soldiers. So Wexford initially won the Battle of New Ross. Unfortunately, due to poor discipline, they lost the battle eventually because they left the bridge exposed. They allowed the British forces to get back over and defeat them. And after that, they were falling back and were eventually defeated at Vinegar Hill. Second reason why the rebellion failed was the government forces were stronger. They had better weapons. They had a trained army. They had a part-time army of yeomen and a full-time militia in the country. The men who fought for Ireland were not trained soldiers. And the final part of that is that the British under General Lake had rounded up weapons before the rebellion even took place. So they'd been going around taking any guns they could find around the place because they had word that there was talk of a rebellion. So they went around, they took any weapons that could have been used. The main weapon of the 1798 rebellion was a pike, which was a long lance with a pike on the end of it. And they were coming up against muskets, and they were coming up against cannons, and they just were not prepared to deal with the strong forces. The third reason that it failed was spies. As I alluded to there, General Lake went around rounding up weapons because they had spies everywhere. And they completely infested the United Irishmen. They knew where to go. They knew that there was going to be weapons, where the rebellions were going to break out. The spies caught the United Irishmen trying to communicate with the French in 1796. They tried them. They knew they were communicating in 1798. They knew all the leaders were, and they arrested them before the rebellion broke out. They knew when the rebellion was planned. So they had this amazing network of spies that kept them in the loop of what was really going on. So nothing was really secret from them. And the fourth reason why the rebellion failed was there just wasn't enough help from the French. Like, they botched a landing at Bantry Bay in 1796. When they landed in Mayo in 1798, the rebellion had already been crushed. There had been no revolt in Mayo. So they had no really real base of support. They only landed with 1,000 troops as well, hoping that the Irish would rise up again. But as far as the Irish were concerned, the rebellion was over. The English did fear the French, and the French would go on to become the most formidable force in Europe for the next 20 years. But they didn't bring that force to Ireland. And had they brought that force, perhaps it could have been a different outcome in 1798. So they're your main four reasons, and we'll discuss more of this in class.